rare to see Evie on water.
How are we?
Fantastic.
You good?
How was your flight?
Yeah. With no food, half the films didn't work.
We have pasta or pasta. I said, I don't want pasta. They went, okay.
Just put it pissed off.
We're not even close to it. We missed the entire fucking...
I know.
We are heading more towards a lake than a town.
I know. I forgot we were going like this way from Philly, so it wasn't the garden.
What happened was is I zigged, but I should have zagged, and then I went zoop instead of flop.
Fuck it! Should have taken that. Fuck! Fucking god!
Are you for real?
This is so impressive. No, we would have realistically been home 30 minutes ago. Not even fucking.
That's what I'm.
This rate, I might as well just drive you back to the airport. And you just might make your flight.
That was your tour of the freaking network of highway system.
I need to pee a little bit.
You need to pee?
No, I just did.
Well, I'm sorry.
Especially after having that near crash experience, really happy to look over and see this.
Is that your deal with your concentration levels while driving?
Gotta stretch my fucking lats.
We're here in Cheeto Burrito right now. This is the knockoff of Chipotle, and Lex is about to indulge. I mean, that was my steak like when I was like super young, and even then I was like kind of like taller than most people, more than average, but yeah.
And obviously you practice with flip-flops.
Like, oh, absolutely. It's my little,
just like 2 points.
First meal today, Cheeto Burrito. Then you have Lex trying it for the first time. Kia, what do you give it? How do you compare this to Chipotle, which I'm sure you're used to?
Oh. I'm going to do a Lovato builder.
It's fucking better, boy.
She's
No, it's good. It is.
I'm saying it. I'm taking it. I'm putting it out there. Better than it.
That's what I'm saying. Now I have a credible source to verify me saying that, and yet it's better.
We'll find out in T-minus 15 minutes to whether or not it blows our asshole out. Because Chipotle is an ass blower. No two ways about it. That's how you do it. It's ass blowing.
There's one final review.
We ate too many on the stand.
Really?
At Expos, when we first started. all the English were over in America, so we were all like, Chipotle! 2 burritos a day for 2 days, plus Fiber One bars. We got banned from them because we were stinking the stand out so bad.
Damn.
And we're sat there going, damn, these guests are stinky. It was us.
Maybe some up.
So yeah, if you were in Ohio 2014, we're sorry. It was Chipotle.
People in Arnold Classics, I'm sorry for you guys.
I will swap 455.
Cornelius, what'd you take?
Right now?
You know, it doesn't matter what you took, because you're not going to squat 455.
Well, basically, we got to raise 2 full pairs.
Alright, I found in my cabinet some C4, which pretty much is not that strong pre-workout, but considering it's 9 p.m., I'm going to be fine. But Lex, I think we know exactly... Let me angle this correctly. I think I know... I think we know exactly what you should take, right? 50 milligrams of 1,3-DMF, and that's it. Be a nice harsh crash exactly when you need it. No, I didn't.
What happened?
This no, gone. No.
That's
no.
It.
No.
To the extent that your pharmacist took a great red pill, this.
Oh. That's why you're going to take 2 of them.
Oh, yeah. Then what? End up in the toilet for half an hour.
You throw up? You can throw up. Like, we're all friends here, Lex. It's going to work. The council has approved of the stack. Do you approve of the stack, Mr. Griffin? Do you approve?
Listen, I'm an illegal immigrant here.
Why is he just unnamed, just unbranded, dodgy little Chinese shop?
And you're gonna take one of these to the dome. These are TMG crystals. Now, I literally have no idea what this shit is. But I know it works and it makes you feel good, so.
You'll be okay. Maybe.
What's the white stuff?
That is DLPA, basically like amino acids, and they help with the production of dopamine in your brain.
Okay. So I know this is a DLPA jar, but what did you take out of this and then put back in the jar?
Nothing, right? We don't have to go all Sherlock Holmes in here, even though you are right, but we don't have to worry about that. All you gotta do is be Watson and take this.
Why is a lot of pills?
Because they just decided, I don't know, it just is.
You go back through that x-ray machine glowing. Can I put this in the water? I don't like the silence.
The suspense.
I'm gonna do this. Put this in here.
I would put it in your mouth.
I would just like put it right on your tongue
in
this.
It tastes the best. Yeah, tap a little bit. Yeah, smash it. Yeah, there you go.
Love that.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go. We all make mistakes.
Like a tweaker. Scrabbler.
Can't waste a milligram.
The amount of messages I'm going to send to my mum before we do anything every time.
Can we tell him now, Dave? What he really took?
Don't tell him.
Oh, give me the pills!
You'll have a good time, trust me. I can guarantee it.
We took our pre-workouts. It's almost 10 p.m. right now. It's 3 minutes away from being 10. We're headed to Attila's, the South Jersey Mecca. And I have a, because I started my program the other day, I did my squats yesterday. I have incline bench today, just basically a general push workout. Lex, what are you going to be?
I'm going to be doing a beat-a-bitch pump-up session.
A beat-a-bitch
pump-up session.
Now, Lex.
Get ready to get Jersey short. That's what I'm doing.
Here you see it'll say Island Gym. Uh-huh. That's the gym that I'm banned at. Rock Bottom's literally right there, like to the right of, like, against the side wall. Place.
Oh, that was the idiots who kicked you out.
Yep.
Training.
Yep. Those are them.
Wow. Tells your business sense.
Lubish.
Alright.
Luby.
Lex, admiring and appreciating it to us. Yeah, you got all the big names up there. Rest in peace, Rich. Rest in peace. Yeah, look, that's his signature. He signed that shit when he was here.
Ultra Boost.
Yeah, what? It's like, what time is it there? Like, I'm at 5 a.m.
You gonna beat some people up, Lex?
Fuck, it's a water bike.
Is that? You have the look on your face. You're so happy. What does that mean?
Okay, so like normal bags, when you punch them, they're just like solid sand behind there. It's like this walks like a body would walk when you hit it.
Yeah, when you give that some good dick, yeah.
Woo!
It's nice.
Tricky, you've got some gloves I can wear. Oh.
Christmas morning. Me and Chris are back once again, reunited at the incline. Now we rarely get the trains together because Chris like prefers going to Island Gym. He always goes there, but today he decided to go to Attila's, and I was like, shit, Chris, what are you hitting? He's like, push, incline bench, the same thing that I'm doing. So we're back here on the incline, round two.
Always win.
Damn it! Yo!
Oh, Big Ben.
What's up, bro?
What's up, man?
Is your first time at Attila's?
Yeah.
Yeah, good shit, good shit. What's up, bro?
Dang, you're a lot taller, so.
This is your life hack. Take them sideways, you get better pitches.
Thank you for making the time to come out and see us, dude. Appreciate it.
Dude, it's getting cold tonight here.
Yeah, no, literally just recently the weather just started becoming like shit. I don't know why. It was so good recently, so warm. Hopefully we'll be able to go to the beach. You can't tell me you're gonna feel euphoric from that precision selective pre-workout.
I should have been dying and I wasn't.
Yeah.
And I don't feel sick, I didn't feel like.
Did you know that sociopaths release 4 times more dopamine when they take like amphetamines or like any other stimulants?
Oh really?
Yeah.
I'm definitely a bit sociopath, but I don't wouldn't class myself as a total sociopath.
No, you could absolutely have like severe sociopathic traits and not have like the sociopathic disorder.
Like I definitely do. Because like, at certain points I just don't give a like if people are really upset and it annoys me rather than me feeling bad about it, I get annoyed. You're not introverted around when you're in a comfort zone. You're not.
Introverts do well in a small group of like people that are like kind of like close to them, I guess, or just in a small group of people. But like extroverts, they're just better at large, huge social gatherings, being like cool with everyone.
I'm not a massive extrovert, but I'm not an introvert. It depends what mood I'm in. It depends how much like I can fake it.
Like, fucking sociopath. I just had a huge period of just like completely reworking, reframe, doing just go starting from scratch with like my squat and deadlift.
I don't stay consistent with them. Like I do them, but then I let go and do a lot of circuit training and like bag work and stuff, and then I'm so fucked up. I don't feel like strong enough under the bar that I can do anything significant.
Especially
so unstable.
If you're like not in like a caloric surplus, just doing like heavy, high volume squats, deadlifts, just fucking dead.
Yeah, that's true.
Nice. Quick little pre-workout aftermath. Lex found the least smelliest shaker in the house.
It's supposed to have been in an on dishwasher. I mean,
they've been dishwashed like in 8 cycles.
Well, they've been dishwashing like cold water. You just put a little bit of hand soap in there. Good.
And just kind of like give it a few taps, all good. And I just got some Frosted Flakes cereal for some quick carbs after my workout. And yeah, those are our post-workout snacks.
So right as I was about like to go out to start vlogging on the board right there. I'm vlogging with this camera. Careful, don't do that. Just leave it. Wait till someone stands on it. But literally, no, I just dropped this camera and the battery flew out. Now it won't turn on even with the battery in there. So this thing, unfortunately, is probably dead. Man, did I get a warranty on it? I really hope I got a warranty on it. But there's more fun things to do right now to get my mind off the loss of my child. I kind of feel like Daenerys from the last season of Game of Thrones. You know, one of my babies just got
the thick grip tape. That's always the back. The motors are in the back.
Take it down to bitch level, please.
Yeah, this is bitch level. So being able to ride on a skateboard is like an advantage, obviously, but the thing you have to put in with this is that you have to lean into your acceleration, right?
Lean in.
Yeah, so otherwise the board will just fly from under you. And when you're braking, you just gotta lean back and you just roll the thing backward. Just
How does it brake now? Oh, okay.
Yeah, you just roll it backward. Just be careful, a little bit more sensitive with the braking. You want me to get it for you? I promise I won't drop it like I dropped mine. I'll drop it way less. A wider stance is obviously better for like stability and shit.
That is a boosted board. Completed.
One fourth.
Done. What we're going to do is we're going to speed that up by like 120% on the frame rate. Put some music over the top. Make it look like I'm nice statting it around.
Do you want me to show you just what sport mode looks like real quick? Just rip it up and down?
Yeah, okay. I ain't doing that.
All that wiggling?
Wiggling? No, you don't have to do the wiggling.
Mine will be with a wiggle, wiggle, bam.
Alright, so was this day 2 or 3?
Day 3, Jesus Christ.
Time flies. Alright, anyway, the weather lately has been not so nice. It's been very grim, rainy, cold actually. But yeah, it's sunny out finally. Lex is disgusted by our shaker cups because they're just so nasty. You can put them through the most harshest cleaning cycle, that the smell just won't go away. If we could send people to the moon.
Ass. Literally like an ass.
I mean, that would be a compliment for it. But yeah, if we could send people to the moon, how can we not invent a shaker cup that won't smell? Think about it. But as I was saying, the weather is just really warm. The sun's out, it's warm, it's nice.
It's a beautiful day, mate.
It's a gorgeous day, and we're gonna spend it at the beach. We have made it. It was probably like a 25-minute drive, a little longer than I'm used to because I go to beaches a little closer, maybe like 10, 15 minutes away. But yeah, Cornelius sent me his location, and it was 25 minutes away, and we have made it alive. We have beach chair one, beach chair two. We have our Mavics on us. We're good.
Okay, so apparently you need like some kind of tag or ID form to get on the beach. David's trying to swindle it so that we can sneak in there. Are you going gay for pay?
Yeah, it increases the likelihood of getting in for free. Cornelius just told me over the phone to take your shirt off. But I'm flat and small, so I don't know. It might decrease our chances.
It's cool, I got the angles on you here. You're looking monstrous.
Yeah, Mr. Cornelius, how are the waves today?
They're sick. They were sick earlier.
So, Dill is apparently the best surfer here out of like Dylan and Cornelius. And Cornelius is on the shore. Dill is in the water, so I'm gonna get my Mavic out. I'm gonna find him amongst all these surfers.
Are you using your vent too?
Yeah, I smashed my Mark 5 yesterday.
I saw on his story.
I just smashed the shit out of it. I was just filming and I turned and it just like fell.
That was so brutal. I saw your story. That camera, and you were trying to put it back together. That was such a sad attempt.
Snapchat was the best bit.
No! Wait, you got it live, right?
Live. Yeah, that was perfect. Literally, like, it's perfect. A perfect day to kind of learn, because it's not like, it's flat kind of, and it's also really calm. When you start paddling in the wave, right, you're gonna, like, you'll feel the wave take you a little bit, like, you'll start moving while you'll stop paddling.
If you're paddling like this, you're paddling, you're literally gonna push up here,
yeah,
like, just push up and pop yourself like that, and try to stay a little bit lower.
Yeah. Just like that.
First time surfing, what's the verdict?
Hit two waves,
yeah.
Wiped out 10 times and then got bit by a crab.
I wiped out like 55 times. I think I hit like one or two waves, but where are we grabbing a bite to eat right now?
A place called the Hula Grill, so we can actually get some real food.
So we finished walking a few blocks and we're at this what's this restaurant called?
The Hula Grill.
The Hula Grill, right? And we're gonna sit outside in this wonderful shade.
Lex's traps got red right there because they're just so big, they're so close to the sun.
They
just got fried. Like, it's just right there. Like.
Who stays while the other gets the car?
1-0. 2-0. 3-0.
3-0? What the fuck? It's over.
Oh, 3-3! It's a tiebreaker!
Is this one win?
Oh, wow. No!
He's walking back.
Comeback kid.
Comeback kid.
You lost. You're done.
Thank you.
Alright, so my PR with 100 pounds on the dumbbells for the incline is, I think, a set of 9. So right now I'm basically going to try to hit a set of 10. And realistically, I don't think I could do multiple sets of that today, but I'm going to get one clean set of 10 with that. Then I'm going to lower it to maybe like 80s or 90s, something like that for my last two sets. But yeah, I'll see if I can hit a set of 10, get that one rep PR. Don't need to say what happened there, it's pretty obvious. Alright, so me and Lex have two more sets of incline dumbbell. Lex just did a set with the 80s, I'm gonna drop down, I'm gonna do the same thing, and what you're about to see right now is Ethan Hoover over here is about to do a sick, ruthless edit in 3, 2. Workouts a wrap, had a very, very good session, hit my progressive overload, just felt really good in general, and now we're at Denny's. Now, this is Lex's second time at Denny's. He's been here once before in Washington, D.C. He's absolutely hated it, but
microwave.
You can do the turkey bacon, you want egg whites, pancakes, you can pick five more.
I tell you what I want and you come up with this.
Yes, I will.
That's cool. Yep. So, just out turkey bacon, egg whites, and then some form of pancakes on the side. So, which what do I do for that?
I'm going to put it under this, but you can pick four items because it's four items for...
Okay. I got all you could eat, chocolate chip pancakes, vanilla milkshake. Lex already done his pancakes.
Day. I'm the Trumpster motherfucker.
Na 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 na, hey hey hey, goodbye. Hot topic, Lex's first option. Trying to get the Led Zeppelin wardrobe going.
Don't insult me, you know it's about the Guns N' Roses. This shit has been in style, it's staying in style, it'll always be in style.
Champs.
I don't see him.
Again, with foot action. Oh shit, for $100. How happy are you? Did it fit?
Yeah.
How would you say malls in the US, how are they different from your malls?
Dude, this is the same as Trafford Centre.
It's the same thing?
But we don't have a Trafford Centre in every city. So you have a mall in every city, like the common. Trafford Centre is a place that everyone goes to. Like it's a special place.
It's about 15 minutes to find the shoes. Lex's mouth is on fire now from this slice of pizza. But yeah, he got a slice. What kind is that?
Chicken barbecue.
Chicken barbecue. I just got the sausage pizza.
Yeah. We're about to eat this, go home, get ready, go to the gym. It's pretty much going to be our last meal before we train.
Yeah. Holy shit.
I don't mess around when it's leg day. I'm satisfied with today's caloric intake thus far. I'd like you to introduce you to my friend Ron. He's a very, very honest man. Yeah.
He's probably back in the day. He's watching the podcast.
We got the soup, the salad, scallops,
and chicken and scallops.
So we're home and David hands me this concoction and just expects me to take it blindly.
100 milli-G's on 1-3 and 300 milli-G's of caffeine.
Okay, you know, you said this.
So we're packed, pre-workout's hit, caffeine's hit, green tea's drunk, batteries are charged. Are you ready? In the spirit of things, we lose our sight, and we put our trust in things of this material world. The things that fade away, yet we keep coming back, keep coming back.
So there we go, guys. This is the end of the trip to Jersey with David. We hope you've enjoyed the footage. Hope this has given you a kick-ass motivational feeling to get your ass in the gym and get some work done. We've learned a lot. David's showed me deadlifts. I've told him about volume, on days, off days, intensity.